Alright, so this Knife Thoughts video is going to be on this knife, and this is the Spyderco Insistent. And first of all, huge thank you to my friend Chris for loaning this. I always really love getting to check out new knives, and I'd never seen this knife in person, so I really appreciate getting to check it out and show it off here on the channel. Now, this Insistent, like all of the other knives in Spyderco's line that are named after kind of attributes, admirable attributes, is one of their value folders. So it is made in China, but it is like a lot of their, you know, value knives, the ones I've seen, it's certainly a well-made knife. So I don't think that my friend has adjusted this knife or anything like that. You can see that it is well-centered, not 100% perfect, maybe slightly towards the lock side here, but pretty darn close to perfectly centered. It does have G10 handles, which is a nice touch. It is a liner lock, which is something that is more common on Spyderco's value knives than on their USA made knives, where a similar model, which I'll talk about, might have been a lockback if it was a USA made knife. But then it has the wire clip. I really love Spyderco's wire clip. I think it's very, very functional. And then the blade steel is 8CR13 MOV. So certainly a lower end steel, but a steel that is well proven, easy to sharpen, and holds an edge well enough for most, you know, normal actual daily tasks. So not super high end materials, of course, but this is a $50 knife. So it's a knife that, you know, from a reputable brand is still $50, and a lot of, you know, comparable in quality knives from Chinese manufacturers that are Chinese branded or their own, you know, independent brands are similar price ranges, right? So just a, you know, comparison that I have sitting next to me that I'm going to compare to the size of this is the Civivi Baby Banter, you know, similar price range around $50. And relatively similar materials. So I think that it is pretty well priced compared to the current market. The other thing is that this knife, like a lot of the value knives, it's not the exact same design, but it's kind of like you're getting a similar design to one of the higher end Spydercos without having to pay as much as you would for one of the higher end Spydercos. So for example, and a good example of how the American-made knives of similar design are often lockbacks rather than liner locks, is the Spyderco Native 5. So the Insistent is kind of between the Native 5 and the Little Native, I believe. I don't have a Little Native to compare to, but you can see that it's smaller than the Native 5, but it has a similar design. Semi-similar handle shape, it has the 50-50 choil, and then a semi-similar blade shape. So you kind of get a similar design, you know, at least from a practical and somewhat aesthetic standpoint, while paying less than a third. So I was looking, when I was looking up the price of these, $50 from most dealers, and then a comparable Native 5, meaning the G10 version. So there's the Native 5 lightweight, which is a little bit less expensive, but the G10 version of the Native 5 is like $180. So, you know, paying maybe a little bit less than half as much as the FRN version of the Native 5 and less than a third of the G10 version of the Native 5. So you get it for, you know, a much more budget-friendly price. You can see the size there. And then I'm going to show you a couple size comparisons to some other Chinese-made knives. So again, here is the Baby Banter. The Baby Banter is smaller than the Insistent. And then here is the Wee Banter. The Wee Banter is similar in size. The handle is about the same length, maybe slightly longer. The blade is a little bit longer, but you know, edge-wise, they are pretty similar in edge length. So you can see the Insistent might be between these two, probably a little closer to the Wee Banter. Now, one thing about this knife is that unlike something like the Wee Banter or the Civivi Baby Banter, which run on bearings, these value folders generally run on washers. And while it probably would break in enough to be drop closed smooth, if that's something you care about, these generally, from my experience, are not. So you do have to kind of push the blade closed there. Now, this was actually in my car overnight, and it got really, really cold overnight, so that's probably not helping the action, but it definitely isn't, you know, drop closed like a knife that had a ball bearing pivot would be. But I think that it's a good little option if you're looking to get a knife from, you know, an American company, but not pay American made prices. So, you know, you can get a knife that has a really good design, very comfortable in the hand. I would pretty much always use the 50-50 choil if I was using this knife, but it is pretty comfortable in the hand even without that. And so you get a knife that you can certainly put to good use. You can feel confident in it because it is from a reputable, you know, USA brand, but pay a lot less than you would for a, you know, similar design knife that was made in the USA by the same brand. So I've really enjoyed getting to check out this Insistent. Again, thanks to my friend Chris for loaning it to me. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you give it a thumbs up and leave any comments you have below. Also, make sure you check out my website, knifethoughts.com, where I post articles on knives like this and knife-related topics. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, click the bell, and select all so you know when I post new videos. And last but not least, as always, don't forget to go out and do good.